But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Let me tell you about my great God.
Hey guys, Pastor Tim here. Hope you're ready to start your day off right in God's Word. We are on 2 Samuel chapter 5. Almost said 1 Samuel there, but 2 Samuel chapter 5. Hope you're ready to start your week off right. A lot of things happen in this chapter, all right? David is finally crowned king. He has some victories. He does things correctly. He responds to trials correctly. So there's a lot of different things I think you guys can not only jot down, but things that you could probably circle as the main thing you got out of today's chapter. So be actively reading it. Think about what it is you're reading. Mark those things down and try to find that one thing. You can even have more than one main thing if you want from this chapter. But of course, tell somebody about it. So I'm going to try to do an overview here. I probably won't hit everything because, like I said, a lot of stuff is happening. But we see here at the very beginning, the rest of the elders in Israel, they come to David and they pretty much crown him king of all Israel. All right, so now we finally get to the fulfillment of God's promise to David all the way back from 1 Samuel chapter 16 when Samuel first anoints David to be king of Israel after Saul. So finally it's happened. From the young shepherd boy, now he's finally a king. And there's an interesting phrase that the chapter starts out, these men tell David, "We are bone of thy bone and flesh of thy flesh." And there's a very similar verse in the New Testament, Ephesians 5 verse 30, talking about the Christian to God, saying we are in him, we are bone of his bone and flesh of his flesh, showing just as a child of God, you are in Christ. All right, as a child of God, you're in Christ. And I'm going to get back to it a little bit later because that's going to deal with my main point. But there's several main points you probably could get out of this. For example, after David becomes king, he needs a capital city. So he goes to Jerusalem and wants to make that his capital city. And Jerusalem at this time is not the Jerusalem that we know it to be throughout most of the Bible. It was occupied by the Jebusites. It didn't really belong to the Israelites, but David was going to change that. And we actually see some trash talk, in essence, from the Jebusites. If you were confused when you read the part where you're talking about you can't take our city unless you get rid of the blind and the lame, they weren't talking to David about him trying to get rid of these guys like they're an extermination problem or something, like they're just crowding their streets. They were saying to David, hey, you can't take our city. You can't even defeat our blind and lame people in our city. That's how weak your men are. They didn't fear David in that way. And David and his men definitely proved them wrong. And he was able to capture Jerusalem. But then we see David right after that starting to make some more mistakes, sowing those seeds of sin that he's going to reap consequences of later, in which he... Because he keeps gathering unto himself more wives and concubines and talks about more of the children he had through that. And those are just seeds of sin that he's continuing to sow that we talked about a couple chapters ago. So maybe that could be part of your main point. After that, he has that victory. All of a sudden, his old enemy, the Philistines, come in. Once they hear David is now king, to just cause problems as well. Happens a lot in the Christian life. Satan sometimes waits for us to have times of peace or right after a good victory to all of a sudden tempt us to do wrong again, because sometimes that's when we're most susceptible to temptation. But David wasn't going to have it, all right? He did the right thing. He responded correctly. He asked of God, should I go out to them? God said, yes, go out. I'll give you the victory. And he gave him the victory, all right? So that could be part of your main point. Or we see that the Philistines came back a second time. But this time it was a little different, and David just didn't approach the situation the same way, did the same thing he did last time. He approached God again, asked him what he should do, and God gave him a different strategy, all right? Satan is not always going to use the same temptations in the same way in your life, all right? So don't approach it all the time with the, like carbon copies of what you did in the past. Always go to God for every new trial and temptation that comes in your life and ask for his wisdom and grace to approach those things in your life. Like I said, there's many main things you could get out of this chapter, but once again, my main thing goes all the way back to the beginning with that whole phrase that the elders told David, we are flesh of thy flesh and bone of thy bone, and seeing that verse in the New Testament where Paul is talking about how the children of Christ are in Christ, all right? We are flesh of his flesh and bone in his bone. And what it shows to me is that now is the full Now is the fulfillment of what God promised David all the way when he was a shepherd boy. All right, for the past 7 years after the death of Saul, David was only the king of Judah, while God's will for Israel was for David to be the king of all of Israel. And just as it's God's will for you that that Christ not be just Lord over your church life, but that he be Lord over your entire life. That includes your school, that includes your work, that includes your recreation, whatever it may be. Whether therefore ye eat or drink or whatsoever ye do, do it all to the glory of God. Guys, is God reigning over your whole life? Is he Lord of your life or only Lord of your Sundays? All right, that's not the way it's supposed to be. Just as David was not supposed to be just the king of Judah, he was supposed to be the king of all Israel. We see the fulfillment of that finally here today, and it just kind of is a picture of what we should strive to be each and every day of our lives as well. Is God Lord of your entire life or just your Sundays? I hope that's not the case. That's it for today, guys. I hope you got a lot out of this chapter. Tell somebody about it. Let your parents know. Let your accountability partner know. Just continue that conversation about our great God. Stay safe. Stay healthy. God bless.